I'm going to need some help to answer those questions for sure. And joining us now is Acting California State Geologist Tim McCrink. And Tim, thanks for coming in. We really appreciate it.
Glad to do it.
Well, we haven't seen this kind of activity, this kind of power in the last 20 years. So exactly what's going on right now in Southern California?
So this area has actually been experiencing large earthquakes for a while. In 1872, there was the Owens Valley earthquake. It was a magnitude 7.6. So that was north of this area. 1980, there was a swarm. The biggest earthquake was about a 4.9. Mm-hmm. But that lasted 14 months. So this area is pretty used to a lot of those aftershocks.
We were listening to Marley, and she's talking about how people can't really relax yet out in the Ridgecrest area. So is this area now going to be prone to more quakes in the foreseeable future?
I think people there can expect aftershocks for months, if not years, due to this earthquake. Mm. So it just seems to be part of that territory that aftershocks are very common.
And you know, we hear of like the San Andreas Fault, the Hayward Fault in the Bay Area. People need to be mindful of that. I mean, there are hundreds of fault lines all across the state of California, and they need to be concerned about that as well.
Yes, they should. Out of these earthquakes, we always learn that you need to be prepared wherever you are in California. You may live in a place like Sacramento where it's relatively safe, but, you know, we all visit relatives and friends out in the coast areas where we could be exposed to those same kind of seismic activities.
So, again, we're hearing from people in Ridgecrest. They're concerned that more of these quakes are coming. They're wondering if what they went through Friday is some kind of precursor, a pre-shock to an even bigger earthquake, the so-called big one. What would you tell those people who are a little concerned about that?
We can't predict them.
Right.
It could happen. But we know that as we move away from that 7.1 time-wise, as we get a week away, the probability of another 7 drops dramatically. At the current time, the chance that we'll see a magnitude 7.1 in the next month is about 1%. But we're going to see a lot of magnitude 5s, you know, the ones that kind of shake you up and alarm you. So there's about a 13% chance that we'll see magnitude 6s in the next month.
Okay,
so
that's something
fives,
to watch for.
Fives are to be expected.
All right, well, thanks for doing what you do, Tim McCrink. Appreciate it.